this series we are solving NCERT exemplar problems for class 8 standard students. Wrong answer here. We have taken up unit 7, algebraic expression, identities and factorization. In a previous video we have solved question number 1 to question number 80. Now in this video we are going to start from question number 81 onward. So the first part, question number 81 is, we have to add, and we have been given these expressions. So let us see how we can do it. First step that I will suggest is that write all the expression in brackets. So it will be like this. Now, as you know that you can carry out addition only between the like terms. Like terms means that the variable part must be same. So here the variable is a square bc, and you can see here also the variable part is a square bc. If the variable part is same, it means that these are the like terms. We have to carry out the addition of the numeric coefficient. Here we are having 7 and here 3. 7 plus 3 will be 10. Now here variable is a, b, c square. And you are having another term here, a, b, c square. Now here you see that numeric coefficients, they have opposite sign, minus and plus. In case the numeric coefficient have opposite sign, we have to carry out the arithmetic subtraction. 3 and 2, if you carry out subtraction, answer will be 1. And you have to put the sign of the bigger number. If you compare 3 and 2, if you compare 3 and 2, which number is bigger? 3. Sign of 3 is minus. So you should put a minus sign. This will be 1. You can omit also. If numeric coefficient is 1, there is no need of writing 1. So you can write it like this. This will be your answer. So first insert brackets. I have not written here plus sign. If sign is not written, it automatically means that it is a plus sign. Again, you have to follow the same process. That is, you have to look for the like terms. Here the variable part is ax. One term here you are having 9ax, and another is here. If numeric coefficient is not written, it means numeric coefficient is 1. 9 plus 1 will be 10. Next, by. 3 and another is minus 5. Since the signs are opposite, you have to carry out the arithmetic subtraction. If you carry out subtraction between 5 and 3, answer will be 2. And which number is bigger? 5 is bigger. Hence, we should put the sign of the number 5. 5 is having minus sign. So, answer will be having minus sign. Then this CZ. So, these are the two terms. You cannot see any number here. It means the number here is 1. In other words, the numeric coefficient is minus 1. Here the numeric coefficient is 3 plus 3. If signs are different, you must carry out arithmetic subtraction. If you carry out subtraction, answer will be, which number is bigger? 3. So you must put sign of the bigger number. This you can write as 10ax. Here you can imagine number 1, 1 multiplied by minus 2 will be minus 2. So you can remove this bracket, 10ax minus 2by plus 2cz. So first, insert brackets, plus, remove this comma and write plus. Now bracket open, it will be. So first write out the variable part, x, y square, z square. You cannot see any number here. That means number is 1. In fact, it is plus 1. X, y square, z square. Coefficient is plus 3. Plus 3 and plus 1 will be plus 4. If the sign is plus, you can omit it. Now next. X square, y square, z. Coefficient is plus 3. X square, y square, z. Coefficient is minus. If the signs are different, you must carry out arithmetic subtraction. Which number is bigger? 3 or 9? 9 is bigger. So we should put the sign of number 9. 9 is having minus sign. X square, y, z square. Coefficient is minus 4. Coefficient is minus 4. X square, y, z square. You cannot see any number here. It means it is 1. In fact, it is plus 1. So plus 1 and minus 4. Signs are different. Plus and minus. You must carry out arithmetic subtraction. Now think which number is bigger. 4 or 1? 4 is bigger. And 4 is having minus sign. So you must put here minus sign. This will be your answer. So first insert bracket, remove this comma and write plus sign. Variable part is x square. 5, in fact it's plus 5, here it is minus 2. Numeric coefficients, they are having different sign. So you must carry out arithmetic subtraction. You will get answer 3. Which number is bigger? 5 and 2. If you are to compare 5 and 2, then 5 is bigger. Hence, the sign of the bigger number, plus. Plus sign, it is not compulsory to write. Next, coefficient is minus 3. Coefficient is plus 5. Signs are different. Again, you must carry out arithmetic subtraction. Which number is bigger? 5. Hence, you must put sign of the bigger number. Plus 4, plus 7. Signs are same, so you must carry out arithmetic addition. 7 and 4 is 11 and put the same sign. Now here you can see constant term, minus 9. This is another constant, 13. 13 and 9, signs are different. If signs are different, you must carry out arithmetic subtraction. It will be, which number is bigger? 13. Put the sign of bigger number. This will be your answer. So first insert bracket, remove this comma. P4, numeric coefficient is plus 2. Here you have a numeric coefficient minus 3. Signs are different. You must carry out arithmetic subtraction. 3 is bigger. Write the sign of the bigger number. It is not compulsory to write 1 here. So 1 I am rubbing off. Next is numeric coefficient is minus 3. Numeric coefficient is minus 7. Signs are same. You must carry out arithmetic addition and put the sign. Next, you are having numeric coefficient plus 1. Numeric coefficient minus 3. Signs are different. You must carry out arithmetic subtraction. 3 and 1. Answer will be, which number is bigger? If you compare 3 and 1, 3 is bigger. Hence, you should put sign of the bigger number. Then P, minus 5, minus 1. Sign are same. If you cannot see any number here, it is 1. When the sign are same, you must carry out arithmetic addition. 5 and 1 will be 6. And put the sign, minus. This is constant, plus 7 and minus 12. Signs are different. You must carry out arithmetic subtraction and put the sign of the bigger number. 12 is bigger than 7. This will be your answer. So here, first we must remove this bracket. If you remove this bracket, you have to multiply this monomial with this trinomial. That is, you must multiply 3a with all the terms inside the bracket. You must multiply 3a with a, 3a with minus b, 3a with c. Answer you will get is, first multiply the numeric part, 3. Here you cannot see any number. If you cannot see any number, it means 1. 3 into 1 is 3. And you have to add the exponents or indices of the variable. This is a raised to power 1. And this is also a raised to power 1. So it will be 1 plus 1. Wherever you are multiplying two terms with opposite sign, this is plus and this is minus, always the answer will be minus. If the two terms are having same sign, it will be plus. Either both have positive sign or both have negative sign, answer will be plus. But if one is plus and other is minus, answer will be minus. This is 1. Numeric part is 1. 3 into 1 will be 3. A 3, numeric part is 1. 3 into 1 will be 3. Sign are same. Plus sign, plus sign, plus sign. 3 into 1 is 3. A into C is, if you simplify it, it will be 2. A square. Now you have to add to it. 2 multiplied by 1 will be 2. B A, or you can write it A B. Both are same thing. Plus and minus, sign are different, answer will be 2 multiplied by 1 will be 2. B raised to power 1, B raised to power 1, it will be 1 plus 1. Plus, plus, answer will be plus. 2 into 1 will be 2, B into C will be B. This if you simplify, it will be B square. Now this is A square. There is no other a square. So write it like this only. Then this is ab. Coefficient is minus 3. You are having here. Plus 2 is the coefficient. So these two terms are. Minus sign, plus sign. That means you must carry out arithmetic subtraction. It will be 1. 3 is bigger, so put minus sign. If 1 is the coefficient, it is not compulsory to write. You can rub it also. Plus 3ac, there is no other ac, let write it like this only. Here we are having minus 2b square, there is no other b square. Then last term is bc, there is no bc here. This will be your answer. So here also, we have to first carry out the multiplication process. Plus 3, plus 2. Sign are same, answer will be having plus sign. I am not writing plus because it is not compulsory to write plus. Plus is usually omitted. A multiplied with B, like this. Plus sign, answer will be plus. 3 and 5 is 15. A multiplied with C will be, now you have to plus. 3 into 2 will be 6. Both are having plus sign. A into C. Plus 3, plus 2, sign are same. It will be plus. 3 into 2 is 6. AB, there is no other AB, let it be like this only. AC, plus 15, plus 6, it will be 21 AC. Then BC, there is no other BC, let it be like this only. This will be your answer. So here we have to subtract 5a square b square c square from minus 7a square b square c square. Minus 7, subtract. So it will be, you cannot see any number here. In case you are not able to see any number here, it means it is 1. What is the meaning of this bracket? Meaning of this bracket is you have to multiply minus 1 with plus 5a square b square c square. Minus 1 multiplied with plus 5. Signs are different. In case signs are different, you must put a minus sign. 5 into 1 will be 5. And write the variable part like that only. Now here, minus 7, minus 5. In case the sign are same, if both the terms are having plus sign or both are having minus sign, that means you must carry out arithmetic addition. 7 and 5 will be 12 and put the sign. Variable part, let it be like this only. This will be your answer. You have to subtract 6x square minus 4xy plus 5y square from 8y square plus 6xy minus 3x square. So let us write it like this. From this you have to subtract. What is the meaning here? You cannot see any number here. It means it is minus 1. This bracket means you must carry out multiplication of minus 1 with all the terms inside the bracket. So you can write it like this. Minus 1 multiplied with 6x square. Signs are different. That means the answer will be having minus sign. 6 into 1 is 6. Minus 1, minus 4. Signs are same. So answer will be having plus sign. 1 to 4 is 4. Minus plus sign are different. That means answer will be having minus sign. 1 into 5 is 5. And then y square. So here you are having 8y square. And here you are having minus 5. If signs are different, you must carry out arithmetic subtraction. It will be 3. Bigger number is 8. Hence the sign will be plus. Plus sign is usually not written. I am not writing here the plus sign. The next is xy. Numeric coefficient is plus 6 and plus 4. Sign are same. You must carry out addition and put the sign. Now this is x square. Sign are same. You must carry out arithmetic addition. 6 and 3 will be 9 and put the sign. This will be your answer. So first write it properly. It will be so this will be like this only. Here you cannot see any number. It means you have to assume here 1 is written. Like this. This bracket means you must multiply minus 1 with all the terms inside the bracket. So here minus 1 multiplied with plus 2. Signs are different. If signs are different, answer will be having minus sign. 2 into 1 is 2. Minus 1 plus 4. Signs are different. Answer will be having minus sign. 4 into 1 is 4. Minus sign, minus sign. Signs are same. Answer will be having plus sign. 5 into 1 is 5. So this is minus 10. This is minus 4. Signs are same. Minus 4, minus 10. You must carry out arithmetic addition and put the sign. A, B square, C square. So this is plus 4, minus 2. Signs are different. You must carry out subtraction. 4 is bigger as compared to 2. Sign of 4 is plus. You must put plus sign. A square, B, C square. Plus 2, plus 5. Signs are same. You must carry out addition. 2 and 5, 7. And put the sign. This will be your answer. So first write properly. It will be subtract 3t4 raised to power 4. If you cannot see any number here, it means, and this bracket means you must multiply minus 1 with all the terms given inside the bracket. Minus and plus, signs are different. Answer will be having minus sign. 3 to 1 is 3. Minus sign, answer will be having plus sign because sign are same. 4 into 1 is 4. plus and minus, sign are different. Answer will be having minus sign. 2 and 1 is 2. Minus sign, answer will be having plus. 1 into 6 is 60. Minus sign, plus sign. Signs are different, so answer will be having minus sign. 6 into 1 is, this means t raised to power 4, minus 4, minus 3. Signs are same, you must carry out arithmetic addition and put the sign. Then 4t cube, 4 t raised to power 3, 8 into t raised to power 3. Sign are same, plus and plus. That means you must carry out arithmetic addition. 8 and 4 is 12. For t square, minus 4, minus 2. Sign are same. You must carry out addition and put the sign. T, minus 2, plus 6. Sign are different. You must carry out subtraction. Put the sign of bigger number. 6 is bigger. Plus 11, minus 6. Sign are different. Carry out subtraction. 11 is bigger, so sign of bigger number. This will be your answer. So first write it properly. So it will be, if no number is written here, it means you can assume here 1. This bracket means you must multiply minus 1 with all the terms written inside the bracket. Minus multiplied with plus. Signs are different. Answer will be having minus sign. 2 into 1 is 2. Minus plus. Signs are different. Answer will be 5 into 1 is minus minus. Signs are same. Answer will be 1 into 7 will be AB, AB. 5 and 2. Signs are different. You must carry out arithmetic subtraction. 5 is bigger, so answer will be having plus sign. Minus 2, minus 5. Signs are same. You must carry out arithmetic addition and put the sign. AC, minus 2, plus 7. Signs are different. You must carry out arithmetic subtraction. 7 is bigger. So we will put sign of bigger number. A, B, C. There is no other term A, B, C. Let it be like this only. A, C. So this A, C we have accounted for already. So this will be your answer. So first write it properly. From this we have to subtract. So here this bracket means you have to multiply 8p with both the term inside the bracket. 8 and 2, sign are same. So answer will be having plus sign. As plus sign is not compulsory, I am not writing here the plus sign. 8 into 2 is 16. This is p raised to power 1. This is also p raised to power 1. So it will be 1 plus 1. Plus 8 minus 7. Sign are different. So answer will be having minus sign. 8 into 7 is p cube. Minus and plus. Sign are different. That means answer will be having minus sign. 7 into 3 is 21. P into minus and plus. Sign are different. Answer will be having minus sign. 7 into 7 is t raised to power 1 plus t raised to power 1. If you simplify, it will be p square. And also it will be p square. For p square, plus 16 minus 49. Sign are different. You must carry out subtraction. It will be 49 is bigger. So sign of the bigger number. Here, sign are same. You must carry out arithmetic addition and put the sign. So first write it properly. This bracket means you must multiply 3p with all the term inside the bracket. Plus and minus, signs are different, so answer will be minus. You cannot see any number here, it means it is 1. 3 into 1 is p raised to power 1, and here also p raised to power 1. Plus 3 minus 1, it will be plus 3 minus 1. You cannot see any number here, it means you can assume minus 1 minus 3, signs are same. 1 into 3 is minus and plus, sign will be 1 into 3 is minus 1 plus 3, it will be, this will be minus sign plus sign, signs are different. It means you must carry out arithmetic subtraction. 3 minus 3 will be 0, 0 into t square will be 0, or you can simply cancel it out. PA, there is no other term PA, I am writing it like this only. Minus 3 PR, there is no other term PR. PQ, no other PQ. Minus 3 PX. So we have to carry out the multiplication. This is the first part. So first I am inserting brackets. It will be, the numeric coefficients are having same sign. If the sign is same, you must put a plus sign. Plus sign is not compulsory, you can also omit. So I am not writing plus here. 13 multiplied by 7. P raised to power 1 plus P raised to power 3. Q raised to power 2 plus Q raised to power 2. R raised to power 3 plus R raised to power 1. If you simplify, it will be 3 and 1, 4, 2 and 2, 4, here also 4. This will be your answer. So first write in brackets. Now you can see that signs are same. Plus sign, so answer will be having plus sign. 17 into 3 is x is to power 2, x is to power 1. Y is to power 2, y is to power 1. Z is to power 2, z is to raise to power 1. If you simplify, it will be 2 plus 1, 3. 2 plus 1, 3. 2 plus 1, 3. This will be your answer. So you have to multiply. Both the numeric coefficients are having plus sign. Answer will be plus 15 into 7, x raised to power 1, y raised to power 2, plus y raised to power 1, z raised to power 2. This plus is not compulsory to write. 2 plus 1 is 3. This will be your answer. So, you have to multiply with 11ab with. So, here minus and plus signs are different. That means answer will be having minus sign. 5 into 11 is a raised to power 2, a raised to power 1, b raised to power 1, b raised to power 1, and c. So, this will be 2 and 1, 3. 1 and 1 is 2. Here you can see opposite sign, minus sign, plus sign. So answer will be having minus sign. 13 into 55. A raised to power 3, A raised to power 1. B raised to power 2, B raised to power 1. C raised to power 1, C raised to power 2. This will be A raised to power 4, B raised to power 3, C raised to power 3. This will be your answer. So you have to multiply. That means you must multiply minus 3x square y with both the term inside the bracket. So here you can see minus sign plus sign, because signs are different, hence the answer will be having minus sign. 5 into 3 is 15. x square, y raised to power 1, y raised to power 1, minus sign, signs are identical. That means answer will be having plus sign. If you cannot see any number here, it means numeric coefficient is 1. 1 into 3 is x raised to power 2, x raised to power 1, y raised to power 1, y raised to power 1. If you simplify, it will be, this will be 3, 1 plus 1 is, this will be your answer. So this you can write like this. This means this term, this is a monomial, this is a binomial. You must multiply A, B, C with both the terms inside the bracket. You cannot see any numeric coefficient here, that means it is 1. Similarly here numeric coefficient is 1. Plus sign, answer will be having plus sign. 1 to 1 is 1. A, B raised to power 1, B raised to power 1. C, raised to power 1, C raised to power 1. Similarly here, plus 1 multiplied with plus 1. It will be plus 1, I am not writing, A raised to power 1, A raised to power 1. B, C raised to power 1, C raised to power 1. Now if you simplify, it will be 2, here also 2. This will be 2. So this will be your answer. So this you can write like this. You must multiply 7PQR with all the terms inside the bracket. Plus 7 plus 1. P raised to power 1, P raised to power 1, QR. Plus 7 minus 1. It will be minus P. Q raised to power 1, Q raised to power 1. Plus sign, sign are same. 7 into 1 is, so this will be P square, this will be Q square, this will be R square. This will be your answer. So this you can write it like this. You must multiply this expression with all the terms inside the bracket. Plus and plus, sign are same, answer will be having plus sign. Plus you can omit, I am not writing here plus. No number is present here, it means numeric coefficient is 1, 1 into 1 is 1. 1 also you can omit, it will be x square plus, this is 1, y square plus 1, z square. Plus 1 into minus 1. X square, y square, y raised to power 1, z square, z raised to power 1, plus 1, plus 1, x raised to power 2, x raised to power 1, y raised to power 2, z raised to power 2, z raised to power 1. So this you can simplify. 2 and 1 is 2 and 1 is 2 and 1, 2 and 1. 2 and 1. You must multiply P with both the terms, similarly 6 with both the terms. You cannot see any numeric coefficient here, it is 1. Similarly here, no sign is written, it means it is plus. Plus 1 into plus 1 will be 1. 1 I am not writing, P into Q. Plus and minus, signs are different, so answer will be having minus sign. 1 into 7 is 7. Plus and plus, sign are same, answer will be having plus sign. 6 into 1 is 6. Plus and minus, signs are different, so answer will be having minus sign. 7 into 6 is, this will be your answer. So first write down the question. Multiplication with 0 will be 0. 0 multiplied with 6 and my answer will be 0. First note down the question. A multiplied by A raised to power 5 multiplied by A raised to power 6. This is A raised to power 1. this will be plus 6. This will be your answer. Write it properly. So here you can see minus sign, minus sign. If you are multiplying minus sign with minus sign, that is sign are same, the answer will be having plus sign. 7 into 1 is 7. You do not need to write plus sign here, so I would have written plus sign. Plus sign multiplied with minus sign, that is unlike sign, opposite signs or different sign, then the answer will always have minus sign. 13 into 7 is s raised to power 1, s raised to power 1, t raised to power 1, t raised to power 2. So this will be s raised to power 2, t raised to power 3. So this you can write down. When you cannot see any numeric coefficient, that means here you have to assume 1. 1 into 3 is 3. Plus sign. Plus sign. When the signs are same, that means the answer will also have a plus sign. It is not compulsory to write plus sign, so plus sign is usually omitted. B raised to power 3. B raised to power 2. Here we are having, again you can see signs are same, plus plus, so answer will be having plus sign. 7 into 3 is b raised to power 5, b raised to power 5. If you solve, it will be b raised to power 10. It is not compulsory to write plus sign, I am rubbing it, so it will be like this. This will be your answer. So this will be minus sign, plus sign. When the signs are different, answer will always have minus sign. So this 3 you can cancel. It will be r is to power 1, r is to power 3. S is to power 1, s is to power 2. This if you simplify, it will be, this will be. So this you can further simplify. This will be your answer. So write it down properly. Here you can make use of one identity, one expansion, you know, a minus b into a plus b. This will be a square minus b square. If you compare, then this a is written here as a square, and this b instead of b, you can write here b square. So that means your answer will be minus a square square, this b is b square, minus sign. You must know how to solve these indices or exponent. It will be, this will be your answer. Or otherwise, you can multiply this a square with both the terms here and then b square with both the terms here. I will show you how. Plus sign, plus sign. So answer will be having plus sign. A raised to power 2 plus a raised to power 2. Plus sign, plus sign. A raised to power 2, b raised to power. Minus sign, plus sign. So answer will be having minus sign. B raised to power 2, a raised to power 2. Minus sign, plus sign. Answer will be minus sign. B raised to power 2, b raised to power 2. You can cancel out this thing, these two terms, and if you solve, then this will be 2 plus 2, 4. These two terms you can cancel. B raised to power 4. A 4 minus B raised to power. Same answer. So this will be, so this is A into B plus C raised to power 1. This is also A into B plus C raised to power 1. So this you can write raised to power 1 plus 1. Or this will be square. So here you can make use of one identity. This will be equal to, instead of a, you have to take ab. Instead of this a, you have to take ab. Instead of this b, you have to take See, if you compare this equation with here. So here a square. So instead of a square, you can write here plus 2 instead of a, instead of b plus c square. So this will be your answer. So this will be, so again pq minus 2r, this is raised to power 1. This is pq minus 2r raised to power 1. So this you can write pq minus 2r raised to power 1 plus 1. You can write here pq minus 2r raised to power 2. So here you can make use of this expansion, this identity, a minus b square will be equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. Instead of this a, if you take here pq, so this is equal to a. Instead of b, you have been given here 2r. So if you compare, instead of a square, you have to write pq whole square minus 2. Instead of a, write pq. Instead of b, you can write here 2r plus b square. Instead of b, you can write here 2r whole square. So this, if you simplify, it will be p square q square minus 2 pq minus 2, and here you are having plus 2. Multiplication between minus and plus, that is different sign, will always be minus. And 2 into 2 is 4. You can write here 4. This 2 will go. So it will be minus 4 pqr. 2 square is 4 and r square. This will be your answer. So write down what has been given. You have to multiply 3 upon 4x by both the terms inside bracket. Similarly, 4 by 3y, you must multiply with both the terms inside bracket. So if you multiply 3 by 4x with 2 upon 3x, plus sign, if the signs are same, answer will be having a plus sign. This 3 you can cancel out, this 2 you can cancel out. 2 here you are having 4. X is to power 1, x is to power 1. 1 plus 1 is plus sign, if signs are same, answer of multiplication will have plus sign. So this will be 9 by 8 xy. This plus sign, it is not compulsory to write, you can omit it. Minus sign, plus sign, if signs are opposite, different signs, then answer will always have minus sign. 4 into 2 is 8, 3 into 3 is 9. Y, and here we are having x. Minus sign, plus sign, signs are different, so answer will have minus sign. This 3 you can cancel, and 2 into 2, 4. Y is to power 1, y is to power 1. This will be y is to power 2. So here you can take LCM, 8 and 9. You can see that they do not have any factor in common except 1. So the LCM will be product of 8 into 9. This will be 8 into 9 is, if you divide 72 by 8, you will get 9. Multiply 9 with this 9. 9 divided by 72 is 8. 8 into 8 is 64. And this minus sign. Then you are having a plus sign. So this will be 80 minus 60, 20 plus 1, 21 minus 4. And the variable part, I forgot to write here, it was xy. So it will be 17 by 72 minus 2y square. This will be your answer. Plus sign, answer will be having plus sign. This 2 you can cancel. P raised to power 2 plus P raised to power 2. Plus sign, minus sign. Signs are different. Answer will have minus sign. It will be 3 into 3. P raised to power 2. Q raised to power 2. Plus and plus. Signs are same. it will be 2 into 2, 4, q square, p square. Plus sign, minus sign, answer will have, this 3 you can cancel, it will be 2. Q raised to power 2, q raised to power 2, that is q raised to power 2 plus 2. So here 2 plus 2 will be 4, no need of writing plus sign, here also 4. So here you can take LCM, 2 and 3 do not have any common factor other than 1. So LCM will be product of 2 and 3, LCM will be 6. Three times is 6, 3 into 9 is 27. This is minus sign, p square q square. 3, 2 times is 6, 2 and 4 are. So you will get here minus 27 and plus 8. Because signs are different, you must carry out arithmetic subtraction. 27 and 8, you will get. Which number is bigger, 27 or 8? 27 is bigger. So answer will have the sign of bigger number, that is 6. This will be your answer. So this you can write plus sign, answer will have plus sign. You cannot see any number here, it means it is 1. 1 into 2 is x is to power 2. X is to power 1, plus sign, answer will have plus sign, 1 into 7 is, and then x square, multiplication between different sign, minus sign, plus sign, answer will be minus sign, 5 into 2 is, x is to power 1, x is to power 1, minus sign, plus sign, 5 into 7 is, and then x, plus sign, answer will have, 6 into 2 is x, plus sign, signs are same, 6 into 7 is, so this plus sign is not compulsory to write, this will be, so here you can see different sign, same variables, that means these are like terms, so this you can simplify. When the signs are different, it means you must carry out arithmetic subtraction. Answer will be 3. Which number is bigger? 10 or 7? 10 is bigger. So sign of 10 you have to put here. And then the variable part. So this you can simplify, it will be minus 3x square. Similarly, here you can see that these are like terms, because they differ only in the numeric coefficient part. Since signs are different, that means we must carry out arithmetic subtraction. 35 and 12 answer will be, 35 is bigger than 12, so we must put sign of the bigger number, that is, and then the variable part. So this if you simplify, it will be minus 23x plus 42. This will be your answer. So this you can write plus sign, so answer will have plus sign. 3 into 2 is 6. X is to power 2, x is to power 2. Plus sign, minus sign, signs are different, so answer will have minus sign. 3 into 4 is x is to power 2, x is to power 1. Plus sign, answer will have plus sign. 3 into 3 is 9, x square. Plus sign, answer will have plus sign. 4 into 2 is x is to power 1, x is to power 2. Plus sign, minus sign. So answer will have a minus sign. Because signs are different. 4 into 4 is 16. X is to power 1, x is to power 1. Plus, so answer will have a plus sign. 4 into 3 is 12 and then x. If signs are different, minus sign and plus sign, so the answer will have minus sign. 8 into 2 is 16. Minus sign, signs are same. Hence, answer will have 8 into 4 is, and then x. Minus sign, plus sign. 8 into 3 is, so this plus sign you can omit. So this will be 2 plus 2 is 4, 2 plus 1 is 3, 1 plus 2 is 3, 1 plus 1 is 2 terms you can simplify. Signs are different, minus and plus. You must carry out arithmetic subtraction and put sign of the bigger number. 12 is bigger, so answer will have minus sign. And if you subtract, it will be 4. So this we can rub. Similarly here, signs are different. You must carry out arithmetic subtraction. 9 and 16, answer will be, and 16 is bigger, so answer will be having sign of the bigger number. So this we can rub. Now here also you are having another x square, minus and minus. If signs are same, you must carry out arithmetic addition. 16 and 7 will be 23 and minus sign. Now here you see plus and plus, sign are same, you must carry out addition. 32 and 12 will be followed by the variable and minus 24. So this you can write plus sign, answer will have plus sign. This is 1, 2 into 1 is x is to power 1, x is to power 1. Plus sign, answer will have plus sign. Here the numeric coefficient is 1, 1 into 2 is x, y. 5 into 2, minus and plus, 2 multiplied with 1, minus and plus, 2 multiplied with 1, y is to power 1, y is to power 1, minus and plus, 5 and 2, minus and plus. So this plus you can rub. 1 plus 1 is, this you can cancel. Plus 10x, minus 3x. So this will be plus 7x. Minus 3y, minus 10y. So it will be 2x square, minus 2y square. This will be your answer. So here you can use identity, a plus b whole square. A plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. So if you compare, then 3x you can take as a, and 2y you can take as b, and then make use of the identity. It will be 3x square plus 2 into 3x into 2y plus 2y whole square plus, here I am inserting this bracket for clarity. Similarly here you can see, you can make use of identity a minus b whole square. So instead of a plus b, this time you can use a minus b. If you use a minus b whole square, then this will be minus 2ab. So again this 3x you can take as a, and this 2y you can take as b. So a square means 3x whole square minus 2 into a is 3x, b is 2y plus b square, 2y whole square. So here you can see 2 into 3x into 2y, and here you are having minus 2 into 3x 2y. So this you can straight away cancel. You will be having 9x square plus 4y square plus, this is again 9x square plus, we are having 4y square. So this if you simplify, 9 and 9 will be 18. So here you can write 18 this is my next square. Similarly here, 4 and 4 will be 8. This will be your answer. So this you can understand as a plus b whole square. You should know this identity, a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. And if you are having a minus b whole square, that is like this, then a square will be like this only, but here instead of plus you will have to write minus 2ab, and this plus b square will be like this. So here we are having a plus b whole square, a minus b whole square. This 3x you can take as a, this 2y you can take as b. Similarly here you can take as a, you can take as b. So here you will get 3x whole square plus 2ab plus 2 plus b square minus, you will get here 3x whole square minus 2 plus, so this will be 9x square. So here you can see minus sign followed by bracket. You can imagine here the number 1, and this bracket means you have to multiply minus 1 with all the terms inside the bracket. If you multiply minus 1 with 9x square, you will get here minus 9x square. Because signs are different, so answer will be having a minus sign. Now here minus 1 multiplied by minus 12xy. Signs are same. You must put a plus sign. 1 into 12 is 12. Minus sign multiplied with plus sign. Signs are different, so answer will be having minus sign. 4 into 1 is 4y square. So this I am rubbing. That means here you will be having, so this 9x square you can cancel. This 4y square also you can cancel. 12 and 12 plus and plus. Sign are same, so you have to carry out arithmetic addition. 12 plus 12 is followed by variable. This will be your answer. So here you can use identity, a plus b whole square. A plus b whole square will be equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. So this 7 by 9a, this you have to take as this whole a, and this 9 by 7b, this identity. Then you can make use of this identity. So a square means 7 upon 9 multiplied by a whole square. Then you are having plus 2ab, so that means plus 2, 7 upon 9a into 9 upon 7b plus b square, that is 9 upon 7, 9 upon 7b whole square minus ab, minus ab. So this I am rubbing. This will be 49 upon 81. A square, here you can cancel out, you will get 2 multiplied by a multiplied by b. This will be 81 by 49 b square. 2ab minus ab, it will be 2 minus 1 is 1. This will be your answer. Here you can use identity, a minus b whole square. This will be equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. So that means this 3 upon 4x, this you can take as a, and this you can take as 4 upon 3y as b. So first you have to write a square, that is 3 upon 4 multiplied by x whole square minus 2 a. A is 3 upon 4x into b, b is 4 upon 3y plus b square plus 4 upon 3 into y whole square plus 2xy. So this whole square, this will be 9 upon 16x square. This 4 you can cancel, this 3 you can cancel, It will be 2 multiplied by x multiplied by y. This will be 60 upon 9 y square minus 2xy plus 2xy, you can cancel. So 9 upon 16 x square plus 16 upon 9. This will be your answer. So this is a plus b whole square. This you can take as a, this you can take as b. It will be a square plus 2ab plus b square. Similarly here it will be, you can take this as a, this as b. So it will be a minus b whole square. These identities you should know. So here you will get 1.5p whole square plus 2 into a into b plus whole square minus, this will be minus 2, this is a square minus 2 ab plus b square. So this if you solve, it will be, this will be 3. So here you cannot see any number, it means you can assume here 1. So it will be like this. This minus sign means you must multiply all the terms inside the bracket with minus 1. Minus 1 multiplied by 2.25p square. Signs are opposite. So answer will be having a minus sign. 1 into 2.25 will be 2.25. So it will be like this. Minus 1 multiplied by minus 3.6q, minus and minus, that means answer should have plus sign. 3.6 into 1 will be 3.6 only. Minus plus, signs are different, so here you should have a minus sign. Now you can remove this bracket. So these terms you can cancel. This will be PQ. This will be your answer.
Wrong answer.
So this you can take as A and 1.5 multiplied by Q you can take as B. So here you can make use of identity A plus B whole square. This will be equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. Similarly here if you take 2.5m as a and 1.5q as b, you can make use of identity a minus b whole square. So suppose you are having here a minus sign, a minus b whole square, then here you have to put a minus sign, a square minus 2ab plus b square. So make use of this identity for both the brackets. Here you will get plus 2 into, so this, and plus, this will be your one bracket, plus if you solve the other bracket it will be, this time instead of plus you have to put a minus sign, 2.5 square. So this will come out to be 6.25 m square. 2.5 into 2 is 5, 5 into 1.5, you will get 7.5 m into q. 15 square, you will get 2.25 and q square. Similarly here, you will get 6.25 m square. This will be minus 2 into 2.5, 5, 5 into 1.5, 7.5, m multiplied by q. This will be plus 2.25 q square. So how you can solve this bracket? You can see here plus sign. So you have to imagine here plus 1. If you want to remove this bracket, you must multiply all the terms in the bracket with plus 1. Plus 1 into 6.25 m square will be 6.25 m square, plus 1 into minus 7.5 m cube will be minus 7.5 m cube, and plus 1 into 2.25 q square will be plus 2.25 q square. So like this you can remove the bracket. Here also this bracket I am removing. So now you can see plus 7.5 m cube minus 7.5 m cube, this you can cancel. You will be left with 6.25 m square plus 6.25. So this will come out to be 12.5 m square. This I am rubbing. So here you will be having 4.5 q square. This will be your answer. So this will be x square minus 4. Here you can imagine number 1. Here also numeric coefficient is plus 1. Plus and plus. Signs are identical. So you will get plus. 1 multiplied by 1 will be 1. This 1 you can omit also. Plus 1 multiplied with plus 4. Plus and plus signs are same. 4 into 1 is. This you can cancel. X square plus x square will be. So here you can use identity a minus b whole square. That means this whole term you should take as a and c you should take as b. So this will be plus 2abc, you can write like that only. This will be minus 2abc. This you can cancel. C square. So here you have to carry out this multiplication, and here again you have to carry out another multiplication. So first let us carry out this multiplication. A you should multiply with all the term inside bracket, minus B you should multiply with all the term inside the bracket. So this will be a raised to power 1 and a square, and this will be a raised to power 1, a raised to power 1, you should write like this, into b. So this is minus b, minus and plus will be minus, minus plus will be, from this you should subtract, this will be. So this will be cube square, this will be cube square, we will get cube square, this will be cube, this will be square. Now this you can cancel, this also you can cancel. So you will be left with a cube minus b cube. Now here this is minus a square b plus a square b, this you can cancel. Similarly here this you can cancel. So you will be having here a cube minus b cube minus, inside bracket you are having a cube plus b cube. Here you can imagine a number 1, that means you should multiply minus 1 with both the terms inside the bracket. Here the numeric coefficient is plus 1. Plus 1 into minus 1, you will be having minus 1 into a cube. This minus, this 1 you can omit here. Similarly here numeric coefficient is 1. 1 into 1 will be 1. Multiplication between unlike sign will be minus b cube. This again 1 you can omit. So this a cube will cancel out. You will be left with minus 2 b cube. This will be your answer. So here you have to carry out multiplication. You must multiply b square with both the term inside bracket, and similarly minus 49 with both the term inside the bracket. So b raised to power 2, this is b raised to power 1. You will get here Then plus and plus, same sign. Minus and plus, multiplication between unlike terms will give you answer in minus. Unlike terms, unlike sign, you will again get minus. So if you solve, this will be b cube. This you can cancel. So this will be your answer. This you can cancel. This will be your answer. So here you can make use of identity. A plus b whole square, a square plus 2ab plus b square. So in case of first bracket, this whole term you should take as a, and here 1.5b you should take as b, and here you should take 4.5b as a and 1.5a as b, and then make use of this identity. So here you will get plus 2 into 4.5a into 1.5b plus, so this you will get for the, if you solve first bracket, for second bracket here you will get 4.5b whole square plus 2 into 4.5b into 1.5a plus, so here you are having 4.5, you want to take it square. So this 4.5 you can write as 4 plus 0.5 whole square. A square will be a square. So this a you can write like this only straight away, a square. And this 4.5, for this I am saying you can write like this, 4 plus 0.5 square. So the benefit is that here you can make use of identity. Now this is a plus b whole square. So a plus b whole square will be a square. So here this 4 you can take as a, and this 0.5 you can take as b. So here you can write, instead of a square, 4 into 4 is 16, plus 2 into 4 is 8, 8 into 5 is 40. It will be 4.0. plus b square, that is 5 to 5 25.25. So this you will get 16 and 4 20 20.25. So here we can write 20.25 a square. Similarly here it will be 20.25 b square. So 4.5 to 2 will be 9, and here it will be, so here you can write 13.5 b. Similarly here 2 into 4.5, this will be 9. 9 into 1.5 will be, you can write here, here I forgot to write a, will be a also. And 15, this is 1.5 square, so this will be 15 square, so it will come out to be 2.25 into b square. So similarly here you will get 2.25 a square. So now if you want to remove this bracket, this you can remove. Here you can imagine number 1 plus 1, if you multiply all the term inside bracket with plus 1, you will get the same terms. So this I am removing. So this if you solve, 20.25 plus 2.25, so this will come out to be 22.5. so it will be 22.5. So this I am rubbing from here. Then this will be 13.5. So this is 26.5. It will be 27.0 BA plus 2.25. So this will also be 22.5 B square. This will be your answer. So here, so here you can make use of identity, a minus b whole square. You should note that a minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. That means this p multiplied by q, this you should take as a, and this q multiplied by r you should take as b. So a square will be p into q whole square minus 2ab, that is minus 2 into pq into qr plus qr square. And this you can write like that only, 4 pq square r. So this will be p square into q square. This will be minus 2p, q raised to power 1, q raised to power 1. So 1 plus 1 will be 2. So here you will get 2. And this r like this one. This will be q square r square. So this you can see minus 2p q square r. This is plus 4. Unlike sign, it means you have to carry out arithmetic subtraction. 4 minus 2 will be 2. And 4 is bigger, so sign of the bigger number. So it will be like this. Now you can rub it. This q square r square. So this will be your answer. So here you can make use of identity. A plus b whole square. You should take this as A and this as B. You know that A plus B whole square is equal to A square plus 2AB plus B square. So this will be S square T whole square plus 2 into S square T into T Q square plus T Q square whole square minus. This square means you have to multiply, you have to take square of 2 as well as the variables. So it will be 2 into 2 is 4, s square, t square, q square. So this if you solve it, it will come out to be s raised to power 4 and t raised to power 2. So here t raised to power 1, t raised to power 1. So it will be t raised to power 1 plus 1 or t square. This q square you are having. This will be t square q raised to power 4. So this you can solve plus 2 s square t square q square. Here you are having minus 4. Unlike sign means you must carry out arithmetic subtraction. 4 into you will get 2. Number 4 is bigger, so you should keep here sign of the bigger number. Now this you can remove. So this will be your answer. So here you can make use of identity. A plus b whole square. This xy you can take as a and this yz you can take as b. So it will be a plus b whole square. Making use of the identity, it will be plus 2 times plus. So you will get here x square y square plus 2 times x. This is y raised to power 1, y raised to power 1. It will be y raised to power 1 plus 1. If you solve it, it will be y square plus y square z square. This will be your answer. So here you can make use of identity a minus b whole square. So this x square y you can take as a and this xy square you can take as b. A minus b whole square will be equal to a square. That is x square y whole square minus 2ab. A here is x square y, b is xy square plus b square. So this if you solve it will be x raised to power 4 y square minus 2. X raised to power 2, x raised to power 1, it will be x raised to power 3, y raised to power 1, y raised to power 2, y raised to power 3, plus this will be x square, y raised to power 4. This will be your answer. So this you can solve making use of identity, a plus b whole square. So here this 4 upon 5a, this is you can take as one term. 5 upon 4b as the second term. So you will get here 4 upon 5a whole square plus 2. This whole term you can take as a. This will be b. And then 5 upon 4b whole square. So this if you solve you will get 16 by 25 a square. This you can cancel. You will be left with plus 2ab plus 25 by 16 b square. This will be your answer. So this we can solve making use of identity a minus b whole square. A minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. So this square, this you can take as a, this you can take as b. So here you will get minus 2 into, this is your a, 2 upon 3x, this is your b, 3 upon 2y plus b square, so 3 upon 2y whole square. So this you can solve, it will be 4 upon 9x square, this 2 you can cancel, this 3 you can cancel, you will be left with minus 2xy plus it will be 9 by 4y square. This will be your answer. So again here a plus b whole square, a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. So here you can write plus 2 into this you can take as a, this term as b, 4 upon 5, this is 5 upon 3 cube plus 5 upon 3 cube square whole square. So this if you solve you will get, this you can cancel, 8 upon 3, this will be your answer. So here you must know one identity, x plus a into x plus b. This if you solve it will be x square plus a plus b into x plus ab. Here this 3 you can take as a, so it will be x plus a, and this 7 you can take as b. So you should write x square, answer will be plus in bracket a plus b, that is 3 plus 7 into x plus 3 into 7 will be 21. So this will be x square plus, here I forgot plus sign, it will be x square plus 10x plus 21. This will be your answer. So this you can write like this, 2x plus 9 into 2x plus in bracket minus 7. So here you can make use of identity x plus a into x plus b. This will be equal to x square plus a plus bx plus ab. So this 2x, if you compare, this 2x is actually a, and this 9, sorry, this 2x is actually x if you compare with this identity, and this 9 is this a, and in the second bracket this is x. So this 2x you can take as x plus b, so this minus 7 is b. So x square means 2x whole square, it will be like this, a plus b, so that is 9 plus b is here minus 7 plus ab, that is 9 into minus 7. So this if you solve it will be 2 into 2 is 4, 4x square. Here you can imagine number 1 plus 1 into minus 7, you will get here minus 7, because multiplication between unlike sign will always give you minus, answer a minus, so it will be minus 7. 9 minus 7 will be 2, and here you are having x according to the identity, so you will write here, there I forgot to write x, x in our case is 2x, so you will get here 9 minus 7 2, 2 into 2 you will get here 4x plus into minus multiplication minus 9 7 63, you will get here minus 63. This will be your answer. So this is again x plus a into x plus b. According to identity you should get here x square plus a plus b into x plus ab. So this whole term is x, this y upon 4 is a, again this whole term is x, this term is b. So x square, it means plus a, a is, we should have a, This is A plus B into X. X is 4X upon 5 plus AB, that is Y upon 4 into 3Y upon 4. So this, if you solve, you will get here 16x square upon 25. Then here you will get 4 LCM you can take, 3y plus y, 4y upon 4, 4 you can cancel. So this 4 you can cancel. Here 4xy upon 5. This will be 3y square upon 16. This will be your answer. So in this question, there is
printing error.
Actually, here it should be printed 2 upon 3a. Now you can make use of identity a minus b into a plus b. This will be equal to a square minus b square. So here you will get 2x upon 3 square minus 2a upon 3 square. So this you will get 4x square upon 9 minus 4a square upon 9. This will be your answer. So this is 2x minus 5 raised to power 1, and this is again 2x minus 5y raised to power 1. So this you can also write it like this: 2x minus 5y raised to power 1 plus 1. If you simplify, it will be 2. So here you can make use of identity a minus b whole square. Imagine 2x as a and this as b. So a minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. So it will be 2x square minus 2x into 5y plus 5y whole square. So this will be 4x square, 2 into 4 and 5, 20 plus. So this will be your answer. So this is a plus b into a minus b. You know identity, a plus b into a minus b. This will be equal to a square minus b square. Similarly here, 2a upon 3 whole square minus b upon 3 whole square. So this will be 4a square upon 9. This will be b square upon 9. So this will be your answer. So here you can make use of identity a plus b into a minus b. The identity is a plus b into a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. So you will have to imagine x square, this is a, and y square is b. So it will be a plus b into a minus b. The answer will be a square. So instead of a, you have to write here x square whole square minus y square whole square. You must know how to solve the indices. If you solve the exponent, it will come out to be x raised to power 4. This will be y raised to power 4. This will be your answer. So this you can solve using a plus b whole square. A plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. So here this a square, if you compare with identity, this you have to take as a, and this b square you have to take as b. So the first term in the expansion is a square. So you will have a square whole square plus 2 into, instead of a you have to write a square, instead of b you have to write here b square plus b square whole square. So this will come out to be a to power 4 plus 2 a square plus b to power 4. So this you can solve using a plus b whole square. This you should take as a, this you should take as b. It will be a square plus 2ab plus b square. So you will get here plus, so this if you solve it will be plus 25. This will be your answer. So this is a minus b whole square. This term you can understand as a, this term as b. So it is a minus b whole square. A minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2a into b plus b square. So if you solve it will be 0.81 p square. This will be 9 into 1.8. 18 into 5 is 9. 2 decimals. 1.8 and 0.5 it will be 0.9 pq. Plus this will be 0.25 q square. This will be your answer. This will be your answer. So dear student, it is very important to do each and every question. Solve each and every question yourself, because as we have solved question number 81 to 85, we could find that there are wrong answers given for several of the exemplar problems. Maybe this is a printing error, printing mistake. So please solve all the questions. In the next video, we shall be solving question number 86 onwards.